Let's go ahead and focus a little bit on face detection. The next two slides are going to be about face detection. The previous ones was about face recognition. Actually, this one is not only about face detection, it's also about learning face attributes. Don't worry about this figure yet. I'm going to break it apart. There is a lot of information here. Let's focus on this part of the figure first. It's your neural network. It's going to take an image as an input. It has convolutional layers and a bunch of max pooling. And then you're going to stop here. These are going to be your features that you're going to work with. There is going to be a head on top of this, which is going to be classification that we are removing here. We are not showing it. So let's focus on LNetO. So that's that one. You're going to pre-train it using the 100 objects that you have from ImageNet data. So you're doing transfer learning. So first you pre-train that neural network. Okay, perfect. One thing that is good about neural networks, and especially convolutional ones, and we saw it before, is that off the shelf, you can use them as localizer. Not only they are detecting objects in your images, they are also localizing. What do I mean? If this is your image, you push it through the architecture that is pre-trained on ImageNet, you stop at this layer. This is going to be a tensor, and then you're going to collapse. You're going to average across the channels. You're going to end up with an image that you can plot. And you can think of this as the average response at this set of feature maps. And you can see it's sort of localizing this person. It's not perfect, but it's sort of localizing. We can look at the heat map and say, probably this is where the face of the person is. But we are not done yet. We want to have better localization. What do you do? You're going to fine-tune LNetO with some attribute tags, which could be, is the person in this image having a baby hair? Do they have no beard? Do they have high cheekbones? Are they smiling, etc.? These are the tags in your image. And using those tags, if a tag exists in an image, you're going to increase the probability of that tag. So if this yi is 1, you're going to increase this. Otherwise, you're going to decrease that probability. So this yi is either a 0 or a 1. And there could be multiple tags for an image. And this is just saying probability of the ith attribute existing in image x. So you fine-tune this architecture. You first pre-trained it on ImageNet. Now you are fine-tuning it. And you are changing the head rather than using a softmax. Now you are using sigmoid. These are going to give you probabilities. And then you fine-tune. Once you fine-tune, you can do the same exercise that we just did. Average across the channels of your feature maps at layer 5 or at convolution layer 5. And then it's localizing the face of the person better. Now this is cool. We are going to use this to focus on the face of the person for the next stage. So we are going to try to crop the face of the person. Okay, how would you do that? You're going to call edge box. Edge box is like selective search. It's going to put boxes, a lot of boxes on your image. You can take one of these boxes and then compute the corresponding average feature or average response map, which you are plotting here. And then you're going to collapse that again across the pixels as well. And that's going to give you a single number. It's going to give you a single score for that box. But your edge box is proposing you multiple boxes. Now you can score all of them. You have a score per each box. And you're going to pick the box that has the highest score. But then there is some normalization going on. You're normalizing by the box size or by the window size. And this way, you can focus on the face of that person and crop it out for the next stage. Now you're in the next stage. You're in LNet S. And then you're going to repeat the same steps. Steps 1, 2, and 3 again for LNet S. You're focusing on the face of the person. And then you're cropping it out. So now you're zooming in on the face of the person. Okay, so far, so good. Then you're going to have this ANet architecture that you're going to be training. So LNet S is very similar to LNet O, where it's exactly the same thing. But this one is a little bit different. And I'm going to tell you the differences. For instance, this is global convolution. This is position-sensitive convolution. So these are local convolutions. Each region or each window here is going to have its own weights and biases compared to the next one. So you're not doing parameter sharing globally. you're doing parameter sharing locally. Same thing here, this is local. And then you're gonna end up with some fully connected features that then you're gonna output something. And I'm gonna tell you what that is. So let's pre-train a net with a large number of face identities. And where do you get them? You're gonna get them from celeb faces dataset. And the question is, who is this person? So this is just a classification task. You're pre-training a net because now you localize the face. Now you're focusing on the region of the face. Now you're doing the actual task that you want to do, which is learning face attributes. But for now, let's just predict the identities, pre-train on that data. Why that data? Because we know we are dealing with faces. We are not dealing with cats and dogs anymore. We are dealing with faces. And there is a minor catch here. You're gonna do your pre-training using the softmax loss, which is predicting the identities. And at the same time, you want to have inter-class or intra-class invariance. You want the images or the features coming out of your neural network for images of the same person, so they have the same classes, to be close to each other. So you're creating some intra-class compactness. Okay, so you pre-train ANet. Now it's time to do fine-tuning. You do fine-tuning by your actual task that you're interested in, which is predicting the attributes. Is this person having a wavy hair, no beard, high cheekbones, smiling, etc.? Now your neural network is trained. It has multiple stages. An image goes in. The first neural network is going to focus on a large portion of the face, which could include the shoulders, some portions of the body. The next neural network is going to focus on the face. The face goes in, and then you are predicting the attributes. Okay, perfect. But we are not done yet. When it comes to actual predictions, you are going to keep repeating that multiple times for different boxes or for different regions of your image. Here, you don't need the box proposal. You don't need any edge boxes. These are just a lot of crops of your image. When it comes to, and if you remember for AlexNet, long time ago, we were doing the same thing. We were predicting based on the average of different crops of the image when it came to testing and inference time. You can do that. You can keep cropping your image. You can also train a linear support vector machine on top of that and then predict the face attributes. That's fine. We can definitely do that. But then it's going to end up being slow, because you keep repeating the same operations for every single patch on your image. And you have a lot of patches. And we know that during inference, we want to have algorithms that are fast. What was our solution? We had the same problem long time ago when we were doing object detection. What was our solution? You would go fully convolutional. It means that you can evaluate your convolution in a global fashion, get all of your filters or feature maps, rather than doing the cropping, pushing it through neural networks multiple times. You push your image only once, and then you crop here and then pull, which is just the global pooling within this region. This we were doing, but there is a catch here. This was good for global convolutions, but these are position-sensitive convolutions, especially here. You have different filters from one region to the next region. You are not doing parameter sharing. What is the idea? There is a solution for this first layer. You take your image or these features, you push them through your convolution only once. Actually, you're gonna push it 9 times. It's gonna give you 9 features. Why 9 times? You are turning your local convolutions into global convolutions on your entire image. Your image goes in, it's gonna give you this feature map, goes in, it's gonna give you the second feature map, the third feature map, etc. You look at those boxes, you know the corresponding coordinates on your feature levels, and then you're gonna collapse or you're gonna average pull each individual portion. And this is gonna end up being much faster. This is good. And the problem is caused because you're dealing with local convolutions. So you first turn your local convolutions to global convolutions. You have 9 of them or as many regions as you have. And then you pull per sub region from different local convolutions, which you turn them globally. That's good. But when you want to go to the next stage, which is also a local convolution, you're going to have to repeat yourself, because at the image level, you were fine. when you are doing global convolutions, you are also fine. But now you are doing two local convolutions on top of each other. It means that you need to keep repeating yourself over and over again from this layer onwards. There is a smart way in the paper to avoid that. I don't think we are going to have time to go into details, but you are going to first interweave these features that are coming from the previous layer. How would you do that? For instance, you have four of these features from the previous layer. They're going to have these numbers. Let's just give them indices 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. And then you're going to interweave them one after another. So you're going to skip pixels. You first interweave them, and then you do whatever that we did in the previous stage. First you do interweave operation, then you do the global. You turn your local convolutions into global convolutions, and then you average pool per each local region. And this is going to end up being faster. This is just for the sake of your inference time, reducing it. So if you don't get all of the details here, it doesn't really matter. Okay. What else? You can actually do visualization of your features. This is a new technique for visualization. I think it's interesting to look at it. This one is before fine-tuning, after pre-training. This is after fine-tuning. What are you doing? You look at one of these features, one of these dimensions. You look at your data set. Some of your data are activating this feature the most. Some of them are activating this the second most, and some of them are the lowest activation. And then you average them out. What is the average image? So you first divide your data according to the level of activity of this neuron into three sets, and then you are computing the averages of the images in each set. And this is what you're going to get. Some of these features, for instance, one of these is going to correspond to gender. This is we as human being interpreting it. Some of them, as you increase the level of activity or the response, they correspond to age, face shape, etc. And some other neurons are going to correspond to after fine-tuning, because now you have more fine-grained details. You can say this person, this average person, which corresponds to one of these features, is having brown hair, or this neuron corresponds to a brown hair. This one is black hair. This one is Asian, etc. So we hit multiple objectives with this paper. One of them was localizing faces, and the other one was learning face attributes. And why is this important? Because now you're moving towards general AI. You want your robot to understand whether you have a wavy hair. Are you smiling? Are you happy with them? Or are you angry at them? And this is how you're going to do it. Any questions about this paper? Was everything clear? Okay, perfect. So I guess the only part that wasn't clear, and I didn't go into much details, was this interweaving operation. But the rest of it was pre-training, fine-tuning, pre-training, fine-tuning steps. And you were using multiple data sets, ImageNet, select faces, and the data set corresponding to these attributes.